The following tutorial is brought to you by Radiocarbon Arts Soaring Masterclass Training Series on DVD. Learn new techniques quickly from the best pilots in the sport and take your skills to the next level. This tutorial on using high starts was originally shot for the Soaring Masterclass 3 DVD, but it didn't make the final cut of the program. Please visit radiocarbonart.com for more information on our growing collection of training DVDs for the soaring pilot.
So we thought we'd show you a little bit about high start launches. You know, there's a day when you want to go out and have some practice at the field and you don't want to set up the winch and go through all the effort it takes to get that stuff working. You just want to stretch out a high start and shoot the airplane in the air. What we're going to talk a little bit about is what kind of high starts are available, how much energy you would expect to get out of these high starts, and then what you would use them for, and then if there's any special setup that you really want to consider for the airplane for these high starts. Okay, so when you're contemplating a high start for your practice days, you want to consider a couple of things. Number one, do you want a strong high start that's maybe short and compact that you can sling the glider into the air really quickly? Or do you want to go out on a day where you can actually stretch this thing back and have a lot of stretch, long stretch, but only a little bit of tension? That basically is determined by the diameter of the rubber that you pick for your high start. And if you want a nice, long, stretchy high start, you go for a smaller diameter rubber. You have to kind of get an idea of how much energy your airplane really needs, though. Are you launching a 3-meter airplane? Are you launching a 2-meter airplane, a gentle lady? The lighter the airplane, the smaller diameter rubber you want on your high start. It sounds pretty simple, but really it's kind of important. And when you get up to the bigger airplanes, you almost can't have enough rubber. I mean, it gets down to your physical ability to stretch that rubber back to a point where you can get a decent launch. Hose Monster is a huge, huge diameter rubber that you can use, and I've got some yellow rubber out here that's about a 3/4 inch OD. And we just use it for slinging it up into the air on days like today, and getting the airplane up for a little landing practice or some low-level thermal practice, or just some fun flying. So things to consider if you're out with a gentle lady and you've got your light high start out. There's really nothing to worry about with airplane setup. If you're used to launching it on a winch or something, you simply do the same thing with your gentle lady on the high start. You stretch it back to a comfortable amount of tension, making sure that you get enough tension. You'd rather have a slight bit too much tension than not quite enough tension, in my opinion. And nice straight overhand throw, making sure you're throwing it right down the line, right into the wind with the wings level, and it'll go up just fine. And you just fly it all the way up the line until the line comes off all by itself and you're off and flying. And you step it up into the more high performance models and you get a 3-meter model out with camber control, and you've been launching it on the winch fine. You've got camber set up for that. You can decide whether you want to launch on a smaller diameter, softer high start and use camber like you would on a launch, a winch. Or you can decide to pull out your high powered slingshot high start. And there you have options galore. You can go no camber and zip start the thing into the air. You can throw it overhand. You can actually pull it back by the tail and let go and zip start it, like some of those guys do with the smaller models. But for the most part, really all you're looking for is enough tension to get the model in the air. You don't want the model to pop off. You want to make sure that your elevator and your tow hook is not overly aggressive. And you want it to go ahead and fly up the line far enough where you can actually have some altitude to work with once you come off the line. So difference between winch and high start launches and setup at that point is there really isn't a whole lot to it. I would just watch on being over aggressive with a high start, because once you let go of the model, there's no coming back on the power. The rubber is going to pull until it's done pulling. Okay, so let's talk about ratio of rubber to line on your high start. Couple of rule of thumbs I've heard out there are twice the length of line for the amount of rubber that you have as a minimum, and 4 times the length of line to the amount of rubber you have as a maximum. There's no reason there's a minimum or maximum there. I think the only real issue that you have is a safety issue when you start talking about these larger diameter high starts. I've launched on a high start that's all rubber. The problem with that is if it breaks somewhere, it's a rubber band coming back with maybe the nail attached, maybe not, and it's accelerating until it hits you. Having some line out there is just a really good safety measure. You can be have it fully stretched out and the thing can let go, and by the time the rubber and everything gets to you, it's going to be out of energy. So from a safety concern, it's really good to have a little bit of line on there, and I'd say at least twice the amount of rubber. For height of launch, you start talking about maybe you can stretch that rubber out to triple its length. Well, I'd say if you can stretch the rubber out to triple its length, you'd want to have at least that stretched amount of rubber out on line so you can get a nice high launch on perhaps a softer, smaller diameter high start. So give that some consideration, and you can practice with it. You can start out with a longer length and keep shortening it down until you get something you really like. Another consideration might be you have a small field. So you can only stretch the high start back so far before you have to throw the model. And there you'll probably want a nice, strong, large diameter rubber. As much rubber as you feel like you can get away with without it snapping and hitting you. And enough line to get you away from that rubber in case the inevitable happens. So what kind of line do you use? Well, it's pretty much one of those things where you can use whatever you've got laying around. I've got a lot of monofilament laying around, and broken winch lines for F3B make two or three or four extra high start lines. So I've used monofilament almost exclusively because I have so much of it laying around. There's also a little bit of stretch that the monofilament gives you. I don't know that you really notice it a whole heck of a lot when you're online, but there's definitely some stretch there for you. You can use the nylon winch line that you have laying around. You can borrow some from your club, sort of make it sort of appear in your pocket and tie that onto your high start. And all of them work just fine. You're not really looking for a lot of stretch out of that end of the system anyway. All the stretch and all the power is coming from the rubber. And nylon's probably a little bit easier to manage in the sense that if the monofilament gets nicked, it will break. So one thing you do when you're out flying high starts is make sure that you've got your airplane set up, turned on, and ready to fly before you even hook the slack line high start up to your airplane. The reason is especially on a windy, breezy day like today, you never know if some thermal is going to fly by and try to twist that airplane out of your hand, and you need to get rid of it. And you want to be able to fly it. You don't want to be messing with your airplane, trying to turn it on with tension, and have that wind try to rip the airplane out of your hand. So we're going to go ahead and talk about some of the stretching the high start out techniques that are out there. And I'm really going to concentrate on one. It's the one I do. Really it amounts to hooking up the airplane. And I like to do this without tension on the line, so there's no fighting that's going on with the tension on the high start and holding the airplane. It's very simple to get it all hooked up. Got it on the line down there, parachutes here. This is where I like to grip it. Make sure everything's nice and ready to go before you start building tension on the line. And like I said, I like to start it here when there's no tension, and then start the walk back ready to let go of the airplane at any time. So in order to build tension, we need to straighten out the arm and be ready. So I'm going to lock my arm out so I don't have to worry about my muscles holding it out there. I don't have very many. And I'm going to get the launch ready. I use a little camber in this launch. I'm trying to make sure that the wind isn't ripping the model out of my hand, like right there. Try to keep the wings so that it's keeping the wind from getting under the wing. And when you get ready to throw, turn, make sure you're locked out, make sure that the fuselage is lined up with the line of the airplane or line of the high start. Make sure your radio's on, it should be, and throw it straight out. It's a fun way to fly, and it's fairly safe as long as you throw the model straight. You throw it with enough tension and you throw it hard enough so that the high start does not accelerate the airplane into flying speed. You need to throw it into the flying speed. So that means you have to give some consideration as to your ability to throw it. If you don't think you can throw the model, don't do it yourself. Have somebody do it for you. And that somebody's got to be a qualified somebody. So find somebody that's flown high starts before, thrown high starts before, and proven themselves to be a competent high start launcher. Okay, there's some other methods of holding the airplane for the high start. None of which I really do, just because I feel like I have more control and I'm able to actually throw the airplane harder the way I just demonstrated, you know, from a grip on the front side of the leading edge of the airplane there. But a lot of people may not be able to do that. So one of the ways that you can launch a high start or launch an airplane off a high start is the old tail boom grip. A lot of guys, if you're used to doing this on the winch, I think you can also do it on the high start. The issue here being that when you get the model back and stretched out, you're not going to have a whole lot of power here in your arm to lift the model up over your head and pull it back against the tension of that rubber. And then keeping the wings level on a grip like this is kind of a function of making sure that you got the model flying into the wind the whole time. And there's kind of a lot to think about there. But if that's the only way you can do it and you're by yourself, then you want to make dang sure that when you launch the model, it's going out straight, not up, not down, wings level, and you've got the tow hook and camber set up for launch so that it's not very aggressive. You don't want the model to pull up steeply and run out of airspeed 20 feet off the ground. That's one way you can do it.